Балбук, балбук, прият море, хладната бистра вода. Балбук, 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 пазете я чиста деца.
После того, как берлинская клиника Шарите подтвердила, что Алексей Навальный был отравлен, немецкие и европейские политики стали обращаться к Москве с призывом.
So I was detained early in the morning. I took my younger kids to the nursery school, and so there was no campaigning for the candidate on this morning. So they detained me, they took me to the police. They took me to a room with no surveillance cameras. There were two people. One of them was Алексей Мускунов, who was the head of the secret police department, the Center for Combating Extremism. And they actually told me, give us your phone. So I said, that is my private property. I don't have, according to the law, I don't have to give it to the policeman. The second policeman, he hit me on the stomach. He put my hands on my back, handcuffed me, took away my phone and gave it to Алексей Мускунов, who started to examine my personal messages. And they took my bank cards. And Алексей Мускунов, the head of this secret police, he copied the numbers of my bank cards and he told
why, me. Why?
He said that we will check who you are funded by. So there is a belief among secret police and KGB and all the special services in Russia that Russian activists, if they protect their houses, if they protect their parks, the trees, they are all funded by the State Department of the USA.
Did they mention Alexei Navalny's team?
Right after I was delivered to the police department, my first question was, what's the charge? So what I'm charged of? They didn't give me any official reason. So Alexei Mostunov told me that you're a blogger, you are campaigning for Ivan Zhdanov, the candidate from Navalny, and now we caught you. So we got you. We got you, and he was very happy to arrest me. So he showed his happiness. He told me that if I were from the Caucasus, I would be killed. And if I were in America, I would be shot down. I don't know for what reason, maybe because I was campaigning for Ivan Zhdanov. And he asked me, so do you know how we plant on drugs? So I perceive these messages, they're going to plant on drugs to me. And they said, okay, so we'll get to your family, so we'll search your apartment, we'll search your car. We are watching you. We are watching you, so take care. So I started my activity in 2015 when I set up a regional neighborhood movement where I used to live in Russia. The aim of this neighborhood movement was to support local governance. We supported our neighbors who wanted to become local deputies in local councils in order to protect our district from construction sites, from cutting down trees and from ecological disaster, actually. In order to protect our district, I told people and activists that they should go to elections and vote for independent and opposition candidates, because Putin's party acts not in the interests of common people. So they acted in their own interests and they don't care about parks, about people, about their health and so on.
You don't feel any danger, you feel secure in Bulgaria?
That's a very complicated question. So I understand that we can't get back. And of course it took a lot of thoughts, a lot of doubts inside of me, how to live further, how to organize our life, how our children will feel in new country and so on, new language. But I understood that it's like you have this word in Bulgarian, kismet. It's a kind of kismet. It's a challenge and we've got to just make it as good as possible for the kids. after we have considered all other options and we understood that Bulgaria is the only option.
And do you learn Bulgarian and you're trying to see any possibilities to work and study here?
Yeah, I've finished A1 level in Bulgarian courses. So the kids are talking Bulgarian now, except the youngest, so it's okay. So they can study, they have friends, and they go to some clubs, like football club, before this coronavirus story, so it's okay.
Would you like to come back to Russia, or your family is well in Bulgaria and you would like to stay here?
No matter where we are, but we will be together, but not in Russia, because we understand for sure that it's not safe for him. That means we don't even consider this option. No. Yeah. When we were in Bulgaria, we just maybe a month later, we got a letter from Russian authorities that they can't make search in our apartment because Chupov, this is my husband, has left Russia with all the family. To get this answer, you've got to give this question. That means that Russian police checked this for the whole family, whether we left Russia or not. That means they follow this. I think that this is, was not by chance that they gave this information to us. Just because they didn't have to. There is no such a right, such a rule that they've got to inform. But they did this in official manner. We know that you have left. It was a kind of warning, so don't get back better.
If you had a possibility to talk to Bulgarian Prime Minister or Bulgarian President, how would you tell them your story in a short way?
So I guess Bulgarian Prime Minister is well aware of the situation in Russia, but I would tell him, open your eyes. So if you declare the European development of Bulgaria, follow the European rules. So if you sign under these rules, follow them. So I've been trying to do in Moscow and in Russia and what I'm trying to do here. So if you created the law, follow the law. So don't violate the law. If you created the Geneva Convention, follow the Geneva Convention.
Европейский Союз категорически осуждает то, что выглядит как покушение на жизнь Алексея Навального.